Hey boys and girls, it's Mike here, One Go Short Play, and today we are still on our birthday morning sit-off, playing The Adventures of Tom Sawyer on the NES. I'm basically doing this until Jo comes back. She's with Lucas Barber at playgroup today, I think. Might be Baby Beats, actually, which is where they do songs and have a bit of a dance. And at first he was like a tiny baby, he's like sat there like that. What's going on? And now he's like, I'm doing Baby Beat. Oh, he just sort of stands there watching Laura, the teacher, the person who runs the class, playing the guitar and singing. He just stands there like that, taking it all in. Then he comes over and sings all the songs word for word. Really weird how babies' brains work. You soak up stuff, and then later on, when you don't expect it, you just spit them out at you. And you're like, wow, how did you know that? How did you know the context of that? You just get these weird moments where you'll look at a sheep in a field on the bus and you'll go, E-I-E-I-O, and you're like, wow, not only do you recognise it, it's a sheep, but you then put it together with the song about animals and sheep, and then you pick the relevant bit out of the song, and it's just weird how the brains work, and you see all these like little strings being, dead. All these little sort of strings being made between, you know, being made between associations, that's the word I'm looking for. This is old school. I mean, this is an old looking game. It's clearly limited by the 3 colours and 8x8 squares. And I got that right, is it 3 colours and an 8x8 square? That's what the colour clash, attribute clash thing seems to be based on. It's really hard. Oh, it's really hard. It's fast paced, you've got to be like, twitch. I like it though. But clearly it's limited by the 3 colour thing, and this was from a time, by the looks of it, before they'd even thought about how you deal with that sort of thing. Oh, that was just unlucky, I think. Let's do that again. SATA, I think I said Sega. I was going to say, I doubt it. It's 1989, it's quite a late game. I don't know why it looks so old school, maybe it's a deliberate choice. It's really, really, I need to figure that out. It's really well designed in terms of it's a memory game. The challenges come thick and fast, and you've got to be, you've got to know what button to hit. I don't have to deal with him yet. I've got a feeling I jump and go under his legs. I'm going to try it, if I ever get there again, because, man, it's hard. Once you know, okay, here we go. Jump! Yes! I wish I could save. I could save, I'm not gonna. Oh no! Oh, it's another one! Okay, we know what to do. Just do it right. Oh, come on, Mike. Come on, Mike. You can do this. It's good if you like that sort of thing. I like it. I wouldn't buy it though, because it's not a sort of game I would spend a lot of time on. It's that sort of Donkey Kong thing. Once you know the mechanics and you kind of master how to deal with the mechanics, which I never really have with Donkey Kong, let's face it. I see, you don't even have to jump. Very few people have mastered Donkey Kong. But I remember realising that it's just going to take a lot of time and kind of, you know, developing your skills with regards to dealing with the obstacles that come at you. And games aren't that important. Little games with Twitch mechanics aren't that important. I think certain genres of game can warrant a lot of time. Like an RPG can warrant a lot of your time. You know, deserves a lot of your time. But more twitchy ones, like Donkey Kong as an example, not so much. Oh, that was just silly. Now, I've come quite a long way, so I expect to be in the bowels of that ship now. Yes, that's good. Well done, game. You have passed the test. Oh, no. Just no way. You've got to learn the attack patterns on this game. And that's not a good thing. Someone said it about one of the Shinobi games, that it's a bit like that. Can I continue? Won't let me in the boat. Oh, I can do this bit. That it was all about memory. And it sort of is, but the Shinobi games have a bit more to them. Don't ask me to put my finger on what that is right now while I'm dodging these dudes. Uh-oh, I'm in a really nasty position here. No. So I'm stuck on the step. Actually, he jumped at me and landed on the step. I could have used that. Oh well, we live and learn. But it's not just about memory, it's about learning the patterns of the bodies, learning how they operate and how to exploit them. See, this guy, now, I was stuck there before, but what he does, he jumps up, so now he's on level with me and I can deal with him. So we live and learn. Uh-oh. What we don't want to be is above him. I was lucky, he either hit me or fair, that box wasn't there, so I was too slow. I want to go up really. What do I? I've forgotten what's in that. Doesn't seem very easy to get up. Let's just let him get past. There we go. That was a mouse, isn't there? I'm going to go down. I'm just not dealing with the mouse. Oh, nice. Well done, Mikey, well done. I like this game, weirdly. It's a sort of I was rambling about Twitch games, I can't remember what I was saying, I lost me place! I do like this game, when you start to progress, you really start to progress. I've got a feeling I'm not far from the end of that section, and I want to know what's beyond it. It does, again, it has shades of Shinobi on to it. I like the music too. There's not a lot to dislike about this game, except how hard it is, but it's fair. It's really hard, but it's fair with it. I mean, once you start to... Ah! Uh-oh. once you get a new baddie on, you're just like, oh no, what do I do? Inevitably die. I'm going to leave that there, because it's just starting over and over again. Good game, I like it. The Adventures of Tom Sawyer for the NES. Didn't expect it like that, just subject matter. But the game's good. It's a bit Twitch, it's a bit Donkey Kongy, it's a bit Shinobi-y. It's a bit Wonderboy-y. It's got very old school graphics for quite a late game in the NES's life. But ultimately, I came away from that feeling good about it. It was fun. It was enjoyable. I sort of wanted to go, but let's move on. The Adventures of Tom Sawyer for the NES. Thanks for watching.